Hey guys, Sean Nalawani of EliteImpactLabs.com here with another bodybuilding video lesson for you. And today I want to discuss the topic of creatine cycling and whether or not it's necessary to periodically cycle on and off with your creatine supplementation. So there's no single agreed upon method when it comes to creatine cycling, but it basically involves a period of extended daily creatine use followed by an off period where no creatine is used at all, and that cycle is then repeated over and over again. So this could involve a schedule of 8 weeks on followed by 2 weeks off, or 12 weeks on followed by 4 weeks off, just to give a couple of examples. So do you need to cycle your creatine? Well, a creatine cycle isn't going to hurt you, but the truth is that it's really just unnecessary and it's kind of just a waste of your effort and your focus. There are three main reasons why some people will perform a creatine cycle. The first is to ensure that their body's natural production of creatine remains elevated. The truth here is that there's no evidence to suggest that exogenous creatine supplementation causes any significant or long-lasting drop in natural creatine production when supplementation ceases, and that's because the enzymatic system that is involved with regulating creatine production is extremely sensitive and it adjusts very quickly to increases and decreases in external creatine consumption. Reason number two is to prevent any possible adverse health effects, particularly on the liver and the kidneys. Now, the truth here is that creatine is backed by endless studies. It's the most studied sports supplement in history, and it's always been shown to be completely safe in both the short and the long term with no adverse effects on kidney or liver function ever demonstrated. So cycling off of creatine in order to give your body a rest is completely unnecessary. And the final reason is to maximize the overall effectiveness of the creatine supplementation. A lot of users will claim that they get better results by following a creatine cycle, but this can really be chalked up to nothing more than just a basic placebo effect. I mean, obviously when creatine levels are depleted and then resaturated, it's going to appear as if there are new gains showing up, but this is nothing more than the natural water retention and the strength increases that are produced as the creatine levels gradually build up in the muscle tissue following the off period. The only goal when it comes to creatine supplementation is to achieve full saturation of your muscle tissue, and once that has been accomplished, that creatine is then available for use anytime you need it during your workout. And there is a finite limit as to how much creatine can be stored in your muscle. So cycling on and off is not going to give you any super benefits or super saturate the tissue in order to give you better gains. So the bottom line here is pretty simple. With creatine dosing, just take 3 to 5 grams of high quality monohydrate powder once a day at any time when it's most convenient, and mixed with whatever liquid you want. It's really as easy as that, and there's no need to complicate it any further. If you do want to check out a very high quality creatine monohydrate supplement that also includes beta-alanine as well as a couple of other ingredients, you can check out our MuscleAmp formula using the link in the description box below. If you did find the information in this video useful, as always, please make sure to hit the like button, leave a comment, and subscribe to stay up to date on future videos. Also, make sure to join us over on Facebook for daily articles, videos, tips, and muscle building supplement giveaways. I'm doing this outro backwards. And also grab your 28-day mass building plan using the link in the description box below, which includes a free workout plan, meal plan, and supplement guide. Thanks again for watching this video, and I will talk to you again soon with more free tips.